Hindu politician is going against the Hindu scriptures. Turn the tables over. Why are we in the firing line? Why don't they ask the Hindus? Is it an Indian culture? And further, there was another Hindu politician who said that this is international sports. All these politicians, they belong to the same, whether Hindu, Muslim, Christian. Most of them, the birds of the same feather flock together. You know what did the Hindu politician, they said? It is an international sport. So you should maintain the dress code of the international sports. And people don't know that the clothes she wears, it improves the performance. I say, okay, I agree with you. We have to agree that the clothes that they prescribe, maybe the performance will be better. How much? 0.5%? 1%? Agree. Don't argue. But if we see in history, 20 years back, 25 years back, 15 years back, when women wore dresses while playing sports like badminton, they wore full dresses. Even today in Iran, women are wearing full dresses, wearing scarves and playing. Even if I agree with you that the performance is better wearing shorts, I'm asking the Hindu politician, tomorrow if beach volleyball becomes an international sport, will you send your daughter? Will she wear bikinis? Tomorrow if beach volleyball becomes an international sport, so will you send your daughter wearing a bikini to play beach volleyball? Will the Indian culture give you permission? And we have to agree that in swimming, people wear less clothes so that they can perform better. That day the gents only wear a brief and the women they wear a bikini. But you have to understand and agree that if you wear no clothes, you will get the best performance. So will you prescribe the women to swim nude? Why the double standards? You say no, that is immodest. So your modesty level is here, our modesty level is here. Where is the cutoff point is important. What is modest for you is not modest for me. So why don't you prescribe that in swimming, the men and the women, they should swim nude. It will improve their performance, but no. They have the modesty level. So we should know how to reply and turn the tables over. Unfortunately, we are like sitting ducks. We have made ourselves a laughing stock in the media. Coming to the question, how should the ulamas reply? I am not against the ulamas because they aren't trained in the media. Normally, if someone asks me the Islamic viewpoint, what does Islam say about Sania Mirza being a sportswoman and she's wearing such clothes? Is it right or is it wrong? My reply would be, before I speak about Sania Mirza, I would like to tell you that there are Muslim gents who play cricket in Indian teams and the other teams. Many of them don't offer Salah. Say Muslim says in the book of Salah that the difference between Iman and Kufr is Salah. Salah is the most important pillar after Tawheed. Very important. The biggest sin after Shirk is not offering Salah. So according to me, the Muslim gent sportsmen who play cricket and don't offer Salah are bigger sinner than Sania Mirza. At least Sania Mirza offers Salah. The Muslim actors and actresses, they do Shirk on the screen, they are bigger sinners. I am not trying to defend Sania Mirza. I have to agree, the clothes Sania Mirza is wearing is against Islam. It is haram. But before I say this, I am diluting the effect. This is hikmah. I am diluting. The moment I say Christianity is against it, the effect gets diluted. Hinduism is against it, the effect is diluted. Judaism is against it, effect is diluted. I am speaking about swimming. I am speaking about cricket. But when I give the answer, it is haram, it goes down their throat very well. Otherwise, they cannot digest it. I am saying that fine, at least Sania Mirza is offering Salah. She is a lesser sinner than those Muslim cricketers who don't offer Salah. Full day cricket, 5 day cricket without Salah. Allah has given her Hidayah to offer Salah. Maybe tomorrow she will wear proper Islamic clothes, inshallah.